好，弟兄姊妹，圣诞快乐！
Brothers and sisters, Merry Christmas！
啊，虽然我们不确定主耶稣具体是哪一天出生在这个世界，但是每一年在圣诞节的时候，我们纪念耶稣的降生还是非常有必要的。
Although we do not know the specific day Jesus was born, it is still very important for us to remember the birth of Jesus Christ every Christmas.
那今天呢，我们要来读约翰福音第一章第九到第十三节。
Today we'll read John chapter 1 verses 9 through 13.
我们通过这段经文来再次思想耶稣基督的降生。
Through this passage, let us meditate on the birth of the Lord Jesus.
好，我们先用中文来读这段圣经。
Let's read Chinese first.
那光是真光，照亮一切生在世上的人。他在世界，世界也是借着他造的，世界却不认识他。他到自己的地方来，自己的人倒不接待他。凡接待他的，就是信他名的人。他就赐给他们权柄做神的儿女，这等人不是从血气生的，不是从情欲生的，也不是从人意生的，乃是从神生的。
The true light that gives light to every man was coming into the world. He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to those who believed in his name,He gave the right to become children of God, children born not of natural descent, nor a human decision or a husband's will, but born of God.
我们一起祷告。
Let's pray.
天父，你差派你的独生子降世，这真的是一个令我们欢喜的，也令我们敬畏的一件事。
Father, you sent your only begotten Son into the world, and it is truly joyful and awesome.
因为伟大的神来到了人间。
The great God came to the world.
神与我们同在。
God is with us.
主，我们珍惜这个宝贵的恩典。
How we cherish this precious grace.
我们祈求圣灵打开我们心灵的眼睛，让我们看见耶稣基督就是真光。
We pray for the Holy Spirit to open our spiritual eyes so that we can see that Jesus is the true light.
我们祈求圣灵帮助我们认识你启示的真理。
We ask the Holy Spirit to help you know your truth.
求你来苏醒我们的灵魂。
We pray that you will revive our souls.
奉耶稣基督的名祈求。
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
在圣诞节的时候啊，人们经常唱一首诗歌，叫做《普世欢腾》。
During Christmas time, people often sing a hymn called "Joy to the World."
啊，我很喜欢这首歌。
I like this song.
那这首歌表达了一种很美好的心愿。
This song expresses a kind of good wish.
愿整个世界都因为救主的降生而欢喜快乐。
Joy to the world, the Lord is come.
愿大地来迎接他的君王。
Let earth receive her king.
愿每一个人的心都为耶稣预备地方。
Let every heart prepare him room.
但是现实并不是那么的理想。
However, reality is not so ideal.
事实上，当耶稣降生这个世界的时候，普世欢腾的景象并没有发生。
In fact, when Jesus was born in the world, the joyful scenario of when the whole world did not happen.
的确，牧羊人是欢喜快乐。
Yes, the shepherds rejoiced.
东方的博士也来敬拜耶稣了。
And the wise men from the east came to worship Jesus.
但是他们只是这个世界里面的一小部分人。
But they were only a small part of the world.
而世界上更多的人没有因为耶稣的降生而欢喜。
More people in the world did not rejoice because of the birth of Jesus.
更多的人仍然在黑暗中沉睡。
And many more are still sleeping in the dark.
当希律王听说耶稣降生了，他的心里不是感到高兴欢喜，而是惶恐不安。
When King Herod heard that Jesus was born, he was not happy but frightened.
当耶路撒冷全城的人听说耶稣降生，全城的人也都忐忑不安。
When the whole city of Jerusalem heard that Jesus came, the whole city was frightened.
接下来希律王就下令杀死伯利恒和周边一带地方两岁以内的男婴。
Next, King Herod ordered that all male babies under the age of 2 be killed in Bethlehem and surrounding areas.
希律王想要杀死耶稣。
King Herod wanted to kill Jesus.
当耶稣长大以后，他出去传道。
When Jesus grew up, he went out to preach.
他又被祭司长、长老等犹太的领袖所拒绝。
But he was rejected by the chief priests, elder, and other Jewish leaders.
最终，这些人借着比拉多的手把耶稣钉死在十字架上。
And finally, they crucified Jesus by the hands of Pilate.
耶稣到世上来，他遭到的是拒绝。
Jesus came into the world and he was rejected.
耶稣是要来拯救罪人的，可是为什么这些罪人却要拒绝耶稣呢？
Jesus came to save sinners, but why did sinners reject Jesus?
今天我们读的约翰福音一章九到十三节这段经文，其实给我们提供了答案。
John chapter 1 verses 9 through 13 that we read today will give us the answers.
第九节说，那光是真光，照亮一切生在世上的。
The true light that gives light to every man was coming into the world.
很难想象这个世界上如果没有光，这个世界会是什么样子。
It is hard to imagine what the world would be like without light.
如果没有光，世界上就没有生命。
If there is no light, there will be no life in the world.
如果没有光，动物、植物都没有办法生存。
If there is no light, animals and plants cannot survive.
我们人也没有办法一直活在黑暗里。
And humans cannot always live in the darkness.
在起初创造天地的时候，上帝最先创造的就是光。
When God created the heavens and the earth, the first thing God created was light.
在圣诞节的时候啊，我们喜欢用灯光来做装饰。
And during Christmas time, we like to decorate the trees with lights.
这里的每一个蜡烛，每一盏的灯光。都在提醒我们，耶稣是真光。
Every light and every candle reminds us that Jesus is a true light.
但是我们在这里要说的光，还不是物理学意义上的光，而是指的属灵的生命。
However, light mentioned here does not refer to physical light, but refers to spiritual life.
因为在约翰福音第一章的第四节说，生命在他里头，这生命就是人的光。
Verse 4 says that in him was life.In that the life was the light of men.
耶稣说他就是生命。
Jesus said he is the life.
耶稣是赐生命的主。
And Jesus is the Lord who gives life.
耶稣来到这个世界上，他把真实的生命展现在人类的历史舞台上。
Jesus came to the world and showed the true life in human history.
他把那真实的生命用他的肉身给活了出来。
And he lived out his true life in the flesh.
而且他活出的这是完美的生命。
This is a perfect life.
但就是因为他的生命太美好了，所以世人拒绝他。
But the world rejected him because his life was so good.
为什么呢
？Why?
因为世人都犯了罪，亏缺了神的荣耀。
Because the world has sinned and fallen short of the glory of God.
耶稣完美的生命就好像是一束光，照出了世人的罪恶。
The perfect life of Jesus is like a ray of light illuminating the sinfulness of the world.
而人呢都不喜欢自己的罪恶被曝光。
And people do not like having their sins exposed.
所以世人拒绝耶稣。
Therefore, the world rejects Jesus.
约翰福音第三章也说明了这个道理。
Chapter 3 of the Gospel of John also explains this.
19到20节说，光来到世间，世人因自己的行为是恶的，不爱光，倒爱黑暗，定他们的罪就是在此。凡作恶的便恨光，并不来救光。恐怕他的行为受责备。
This is the verdict. Light has come into the world, but men love darkness instead of the light because their deeds were evil. Everyone who does evil hates the light and will not come into the light for fear that his deeds will be exposed.
这就是为什么耶稣来到他创造的这个世界里，却被他所创造的人所拒绝。
That is why when Jesus came to the world, he was rejected by his people.
世人拒绝耶稣的另外的一个原因，就是因为人们不认识。
Another reason the world rejected Jesus is that the world did not know him.
第十节说，他在世界，世界也是借着他造的，世界却不认识他。
Verse 10 says, he was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world did not know him.
罪啊，不仅会导致人在行为上会作恶，罪也会蒙蔽人的理智。
Sin not only causes people to live immoral lives, but also blinds people's intellect.
在属灵上，人是眼瞎的，不明白真理。
Spiritually, man is blind and cannot understand the truth.
这就是为什么很多人看见了耶稣行的神迹，仿佛没看见一样。
That's why many people saw the miracles performed by Jesus as if they did not see them.
有些人他们刚刚看过耶稣行了一个神迹，又要求耶稣再给他行个神迹看。
And those that had just witnessed a miracle still asked Jesus to show them a miracle.
他们属灵的眼睛是瞎的。
Their spiritual eyes were blind.
他们看不清真相。
And they cannot see the truth.
所以他们拒绝耶稣。
Therefore, Jesus was rejected by many people.
但是耶稣来是要照亮世上的人。
However, Jesus came to give light to every man in the world.
想象一下哈，如果我们是生活在一个黑暗的洞穴里面啊，我们什么也看不见。
Picture this, if we were living in a dark cave where we could not see anything.
突然间有一束光照了进来。 在这个光里面，你可以看清周围的一切了。
And suddenly a beam of light comes in, and we can see everything around us clearly.
我们的眼睛都被照亮了。
We are enlightened.
我们的世界也被照亮了。
Our world illuminated.
可是当光照进来的时候，很多人的选择是闭上眼睛，不要接受光。
However, when the light comes in, many people close their eyes and do not receive the light.
还有很多人躲在黑暗的角落里，不要在光里去观察世界。
Many people hide in dark corners and do not observe things in the light.
所以光虽然照进来了，但是光对于这些人来说没有任何的益处。
Therefore, they do not receive any blessings from the light.
因为世人的思想、意念、认知系统全都被罪所蒙蔽了。
Because man's minds and reasonings are blinded by sin.
如果你要接受耶稣，就意味着你要承认我过去的无神论的观念是错误的。
If you want to accept Jesus, it means that you have to admit that the atheism you believed in is wrong.
我要承认我过去的进化论的信念是错误的。
You have to admit that your faith on evolution is wrong.
我要承认我过去对耶稣的看法也是错误的。
You have to admit that your understanding about Jesus was wrong.
我也要承认我自己的认识也是错误的。
You have to admit that you are also wrong about how you understand yourself.
也就是你必须要重新的归正自己的思想观念。
You have to renew your minds.
这是一种彻底而全面的自我否定。
This is a complete and comprehensive self-denial.
但是人因为有骄傲的本性，不愿意承认自己的观念是错误。
But people are unwilling to admit that their ideas are wrong.
人既不愿
because of their proud nature.
人既不愿意曝光自己的罪恶，人也不愿意承认自己观念的错误。
People are unwilling to expose their sins, nor to admit that their ideas are wrong.
所以人们会拒绝耶稣。
So people reject Jesus.
那些接受过神学培训的文士，要来做这个木匠的儿子的学生，那是需要很大的谦卑的。
It takes a lot of humility for a theologically trained scribe to be the student of a carpenter's son.
一个注重实践律法的法利赛人，要去尊重那位在安息日也做工的耶稣，这需要那个法利赛人有很深刻的自我否定。
What a deep self-denial it took for a Pharisee who tried his best to keep the law to honor Jesus who worked on the Sabbath.
所以像尼哥底母啊，半夜里来找耶稣请教重生的真理，这是一件非常难能可贵的事情。
Therefore, it is very valuable that Nicodemus came to Jesus at night to ask Jesus about the doctrine of regeneration.
但是像尼哥底母这样的人并不多。
However, there are not many people like Nicodemus.
耶稣被更多的人所拒绝。
Jesus was rejected by many more.
耶稣是这个世界的主人。
Jesus is the owner of this world.
他来到自己的世界，这就是他自己的地盘。
When he came to this world, he came to his own territory.
周杰伦唱过一首歌叫《我的地盘，听我的》。
Jay Chou has a song, Listen to Me in My Zone.
可是耶稣来到自己的地盘，这地盘上大部分人都不听他的。
But when Jesus came to his territory, many people did not listen to him.
世人拒绝耶稣。
The world rejects Jesus.
而拒绝的最高峰就是把耶稣钉死在十字架上。
And the most extreme rejection was that they crucified him.
他们不允许耶稣传讲真理。
And they did not allow Jesus to speak the truth.
他们要把这个世界上唯一的一个完美的义人给杀死。
They want to kill the only righteous man in this world.
他们要把真光驱逐出这个世界。
They want to drive the true lights out of this world.
耶稣被钉十字架的时候，遍地都黑暗了。
When Jesus was crucified,Darkness covered the earth.
但是世人想不到的是，耶稣就是通过他在十字架上的死来拯救神的儿女脱离黑暗的权势。
However, what people cannot imagine is that Jesus saved God's children from the power of darkness through his death on the cross.
耶稣第三天从死里复活。
And Jesus was risen from the dead on the third day.
黑暗来了，光明还会远吗？
When the darkness comes, can the light be far behind?
远吗？不远了。
It is not far away.
他是生命的光。
He is the light of life.
不是黑暗侵吞了光，而是光驱走了黑暗。
It is not darkness that engulfs the light, but it is the light that drives away the darkness.
因为耶稣基督已经从死里复活，所以他可以拯救我们脱离黑暗的权势。
Because Jesus Christ has risen from the dead, we can be saved from the power of darkness.
圣灵借着基督复活的大能，叫我们可以重新的活过来。
The Holy Spirit gives us life through the power of Christ's resurrection.
于是我们那石头般刚硬的心变成了肉心。
So our hearts, which were hardened like stone, became soft. flesh.
我们被重生了。
And we were born again.
我们成了上帝的儿女。
We became children of God.
于是在这个普遍拒绝耶稣的世界里，我们却接受了耶稣。
In a world where the majority rejects Jesus, we accept Jesus.
耶稣来是要照亮一切生在世上的。
Jesus gives light to every man in the world.
在第九节的这些经文里面，照亮这个词，它有在理智上启蒙的意思。
The word gives light in verse 9 also means in light.
就是让人属灵的眼睛可以看见。
It also means let the spiritual eyes see.
让人能够明白真理。
To make people understand the truth.
因为耶稣不仅是生命，他也是真理。
Because Jesus is not only life, but he is also truth.
耶稣可以让我们看清这个世界的真相。
Jesus can make us see the reality of this world.
这就是观念的更新和变化。
This is the renewal of our mind.
也就是罗马书十二章所说的心意更新而变化。
It's also what Romans 12 says, being transformed by the renewing of the mind.
还记得有一个瞎子，他遇到耶稣之前，他什么也看不见。
There was a blind man who couldn't see anything until he met Jesus.
耶稣医治了他，他的眼睛可以看见。
Jesus healed him and he could see.
但是呢，他还看不清楚。
But he still could not see clearly.
当他看见人的时候，就好像看见了一棵树一样。
When he saw a man, he saw it like a tree.
然后呢，耶稣又摸了他的眼睛。
Then Jesus touched his eyes again.
他终于看清了人的样子。
And he finally saw the image of man.
然后那个神迹的记载就停在这里了。
Record of this miracle ended here.
但是那个人还需要经历一个神迹。
But this man needed one more miracle.
他属灵的眼睛还需要被打开。
His spiritual eyes needed to be opened.
只有当他属灵的眼睛被真理的光所光照了，他才能够看见原来人生命中背负着神的形象。
However, his spiritual eyes needed to be enlightened by the truth so that he can see a man bearing the image of God.
当你看到另外一个人的时候，只有当你看到他身上背负着神的形象，你才真的看清了这个人的真相。
When you see a person, and only when you see the image of God in him, do you really see the reality of the human being.
当我们看待这个世界里面一切的人事物的眼光都符合圣经的真理，我们才能够经历到一种理智上的启蒙。
When we look at everything and everyone in the world in accordance with the truth, we have experienced intellectual enlightenment.
这就是建立一种符合圣经的一种世界观。
This is to build a biblical worldview.
就是戴上真理的眼镜去看待这个世界里面一切的事物和现象。
Put on the lens of truth to look at all things and phenomena in this world.
C.S. Lewis 他说一句话说，我们相信太阳在夏日中午的天空中，不是因为我们可以清楚地看见太阳，而是因为我们可以因着太阳的存在而看清其他的一切。
C.S. Lewis once said, We believe that the sun is in the sky at midday in summer, not because we can clearly see the sun, but because we can see everything else.
同样的，我们相信基督教的真理，就像我们相信太阳已经升起一样，不是因为我们看见了它，而是因为透过它，我们可以看清其他的一切。
In the same way, I believe in Christianity, as I believe in the sun has risen.Not only because I see it, but because I can see everything else by it.
事实上我们看不见光，但是我们通过光可以看清其他的事。
In fact, we cannot see light, but through light we can see.
我们也看不见耶稣，但是透过耶稣我们可以认识这个世界的真相。
We cannot see Jesus, but through Jesus we can know the truth of this world.
因为耶稣是真光，照亮这个世界。
Because Jesus is a true light, and he gives light to the world.
耶稣是道，道成了肉身来到这个世界。
Jesus is the Word, and the Word became flesh and came to this world.
他的道就是真理启示出来，让我们得到启蒙，从而我们可以认识世界的真相。
The revelation of the Word enlightens us, and thus we can see the truth of the world.
只有这样，我们才能够在生活的各个领域按照真理的原则去生活。
And only then can we live in accordance to the truth in all areas of our life.
所以建立符合圣经的世界观，这是可能的，而且也是必要的。
Therefore, it is possible and necessary to develop a biblical worldview.
Caleb, in. 记得在哪儿看到过这几幅画吗？记得吗？
Do you remember where you saw these paintings?
Yeah, 对，在 Pensacola Christian College 的校园里面，我们看到过这几幅画。
We saw these paintings on the Pensacola Christian College campus.
啊，那一天我们几个人站在这几幅画的面前。
On that day, we stood in front of these paintings.
Pastor Nate 看了一会儿。
And Pastor Nate looked at them for a while.
然后 Pastor Nate 简单的用几句话就讲述了这几幅画和很多后现代的一些艺术作品做一个对比，这几幅画如何反映了基督徒的世界观。
And then Pastor Nate described how these paintings reflect the Christian worldview compared to many works of postmodern art.
还记得吗 ，Pastor Nate? Do you remember that? Yeah. 你不需要学习绘画。
You do not need to learn how to paint.
你也不需要懂得很多色彩和构图的专业知识。
And you don't need to learn the professional knowledge such as color and composition.
你仅仅根据圣经就可以看出这几幅画所反映的基督徒的世界观。
You can see the worldview reflected in these paintings just based on the Bible.
因为耶稣基督启示的真理照亮我们的心思意念。
Because the truth revealed by Jesus Christ gives light in our hearts and in our minds.
真理来塑造我们看待一切事物的眼光。
And the truth shapes the way we see everything.
所以你应该期待2023年可能是在春季以后 Pastor Nate 会在英文班的主日学里讲圣经世界观的课。
In 2023, probably after the spring semester, Pastor Nate will teach a Christian worldview in the English Sunday school class.
啊，从明年开始，或许可能就是从下一次周五团契的一个小组里面，我也重新的讲圣经世界观的课。
And I'll teach a biblical worldview in next year's Friday Fellowship small group.
啊，这次跟两年前会讲的内容有一点的不一样。
It'll be different from what I taught 2 years ago.
啊，过去一段时间 ，Pastor Nate 跟我们找到了一些更好的一些圣经世界观的一些的材料。
Pastor Nate and I found more good biblical worldview resources.
要让真理照亮我们的理智。
Let the truth enlighten our minds.
当然，耶稣的真光不只是让我们在理智上得到启蒙，更重要的是，他还让我们得到真正的生命。
The true light of Jesus not only enlightens our reasoning.But also gives us true life.
第二十三节和十二节和十三节说，凡接待耶稣的人，就是信他名的人，是从神生的。
First Column 13 says, "Those who received and believed in Jesus were born of God."
一个真心接受耶稣的人，是一个重生的人。
A person who truly received Jesus Christ is born again.
重生是生命的改变。
Rebirth is a change of life.
圣灵把耶稣基督的生命赐给我们。
Holy Spirit gives us the life of Jesus Christ.
我们里面有基督的生命。
We have the life of Christ.
我们里面有光啊。
And there's light within us.
所以我们应该彰显出耶稣基督的光。
Therefore, we should manifest the light of Jesus.
也就是让世人从我们的生命中看到基督的生命。
It is to let the world see the light, life of Christ from our life.
耶稣是圣洁的，是公义的，他满有怜悯，满有慈爱。
Christ is holy, righteous, merciful, and loving.
而且耶稣坚持真理，从不妥协。
And he upholds the truth without compromise.
当我们也活出这种生命的特征，我们就如同一束光，照亮了这个世界。
When you live out this characteristic of life, you are like a ray of light, illuminating the world.
但是，这会产生什么结果呢
？And what result will this bring?
当我们的生命如同一束光照亮世界，我们可能遇到两种不同的反应。
When our life is like a ray of light, illuminating the world, we can encounter two different responses.
有一种反应是，有些人可能会因为我们生命的见证，他们被感动。
One response is that some people will be touched by our testimony.
啊，这个时候我们不要忘记提醒他们，千万不要说我是个好人。
At this time, we should not forget to tell them that I am not a good person.
告诉他们，其实我是个罪人。
But in fact, that I am a sinner.
我今日成了何等人，是蒙了神的恩赐。
But by the grace of God, I am what I am.
如果你想要得到丰盛的生命，请接受耶稣做你生命的主。
If you want to have an abundant life, please come and accept Jesus as your Lord of your life.
耶稣才是生命的源头。
Jesus is the source of life.
当我们为耶稣做见证，我们渴望遇到这种很正面的、积极的反应，然后把人引向耶稣。
When we witness for Jesus, we desire to experience this positive response, then we draw people to Jesus.
但是我们很可能也会遇到另外一种不同的反应。
However, it is likely that we encounter a different response.
当我们为主做见证的时候，我们很可能也会被人拒绝。
When we witness for the Lord, we will most likely be rejected.
我们可能会受到逼迫。
We will be persecuted.
因为光照进黑暗里，黑暗却不接受光。
For the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness does not receive the light.
当我们为主而活，当我们要竭力的去效法基督的时候。
So when you live for the Lord and you strive to imitate Christ.
当你要过圣洁的生活，当你不随从不义，只随从真理的时候。
When you live a holy life and when you do not follow evil, but only truth.
你很可能不是受到别人的称赞。
You are most likely not going to be praised by others.
你很可能受到别人的攻击和批评。
You will be criticized and attacked.
上学的同学们，你们在学校里可能会听到一些同学讨论一些很不道德的话题。
In school, you will hear some students discussing some immoral topics.
你可能听说甚至看见一些的同学做一些不道德的事情。
And you will hear or even see some students doing immoral things.
如果你要效法基督，你就不随从他们。
If you're going to imitate Christ,
那么你就如同一束光，照亮了你的学校，照亮了你的教室。
Then you are like a beam of light illuminating your school and your classroom.
结果是什么呢？
And what will happen in the end?
很有可能你会失去一些朋友。
Probably you will lose some friends.
你可能会被冷落。
You might be left out.
如果是这样的话，我为你感到自豪。
And if so, I'm proud of you.
因为为义受逼迫的人有福。
Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake.
你们若为基督的名受辱骂，便是有福。
Blessed are you if you are reproached for the name of Christ's sake.
因为主耶稣在世上的时候，他也被人拒绝，主耶稣也遭遇逼迫。
Because the Lord Jesus was rejected and persecuted by people when he was on earth.
所以你是与基督一同受苦，因此我们有理由欢喜。
So rejoice, therefore, that you share in Christ's suffering.
弟兄姊妹，我们有一个神圣的身份。
We have a divine identity.
我们是神的儿女。
We are children of God.
凡接待他的，就是信他名的人，他就赐给他们权柄，做神的儿女。
To all who received him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God.
这里说神的儿女，它不只是一种身份，它也是一种权利。
Being a child of God is not only a status, but a right.
我们有权柄向天父祷告。
We have the right to pray to our heavenly Father.
我们有权柄参与到拓展神的国度的事情里面去。
And we have the right to participate in the exploration of God's kingdom.
但是权利和责任也是捆绑在一起的。
Our rights and responsibilities are bound together.
每一份权利都携带着一份责任。
With every right comes responsibility.
我们有责任为耶稣做见证。
We have a responsibility to be witnesses for Jesus.
我们有责任把天国的好消息告诉我们周围的人。
We have a responsibility to tell those around us the good news of our kingdom.
我们有责任去照亮这个世界。
And we have a responsibility to give light to this world.
可是当我们承担起这个责任，当我们运用上帝赐给我们的权柄，尝试去照亮这个世界的时候。
When we take up responsibilities, when we use the authority God has given us, when we try to illuminate the world.
当我们这么做，我们可能会被黑暗的力量所拒绝，就像主耶稣所遭遇的一样。
We will be rejected by the power of darkness, just like the Lord Jesus.
但即使我们遭遇拒绝，我们也要为主发光。
Even though we are rejected by the world, we still shine for Jesus.
我们生活在一个不太欢迎耶稣的时代。
We live in an age where Jesus is not welcome.
在中国，圣诞节遭到中国官方的抵制。
In China, Christmas is officially boycotted by the Chinese government.
从根本上来说，他们是拒绝耶稣基督。
Basically, they are rejecting Jesus Christ.
他们是在试图禁止更多的中国人听到耶稣的名字和耶稣拯救人的好消息。
They're trying to prevent Chinese people from hearing the name of Jesus, his good news.
在美国有一些的大公司里面有一种政治正确的江湖规矩，就是你过圣诞节的时候不能说圣诞快乐，只能说节日快乐。
In the United States, in many big companies, there's a kind of politically correct rule. That is, in Christmas, they do not say Merry Christmas, but they can only say Happy Holidays.
我们会看到有关耶稣基督的文字和符号逐渐的从公共领域里面消失。
Words and symbols that relate to Jesus Christ are gradually disappearing from the public sphere.
有一股去基督化的一股文化的现象，本质上是在拒绝基督。
This deep Christian cultural phenomenon is essentially rejecting Jesus.
而我们就是在这样的一种文化背景下，为耶稣做见证，去照亮世界。
We enlighten the world with the light of Jesus in such cultures.
这个世界上黑暗的势力总是想要摧残孩子。
The dark forces in this world are always destroying children.
当耶稣降生之后不久，希律王就要屠杀伯利恒的婴孩。
Soon after Jesus was born, King Herod slaughtered the baby.
在中国，那一股黑暗的势力在历史上用计划生育政策屠杀了不计其数的婴儿。
In China, that dark force used that one-child policy to kill countless babies in history.
但是很多的中国人，包括很多的中国基督徒，都觉得无所谓。
But many Chinese, including Chinese Christians, do not care.
人们不太愿意提这件事。
They don't want to mention it.
因为我们的眼睛被这一股黑暗蒙蔽的太久太久。
Because our eyes have been blinded by this darkness for too long.
但是耶稣是真光。
But Jesus is the true light.
我们应该在光里面看见生命的宝贵，看见婴儿的尊严，看见上帝的形象。
We should see the preciousness of light, the dignity of babies, and the image of God in the light.
曾经在成都的秋雨教会，王一牧师他们举办过反堕胎的公益讲座。
Pastor Wang Yi's Early Rain Church in Chengdu once held a public pro-life event.
他们要让生命和真理的光照耀在中国的大地上。
Let the light of life and truth shine on the land of China.
但这种做法在中国叫做政治不正确。
However, this is politically incorrect in China.
当然，他们也遭遇到政府的打压。
So what they encountered was persecution from the government.
这个世界上黑暗的力量总是摧残孩子。
The dark forces in this world are always destroying children.
在美国，除了堕胎合法化的问题之外，LGBTQ 团体他们也一直在通过教育、媒体、娱乐产业很多的途径给孩子们灌输那些邪恶而荒谬的性观念。
In the United States, in addition to the issue of abortion, LGBTQ groups indoctrinate children with the evil and wrong ideas about gender identity through various channels such as education, media, and entertainment products.
从2015年开始，Drag Queen Story 这个项目就进入美国很多地方的公立学校和公立图书馆里面，包括我们的密西西比。
Since 2015, the Drag Queen Story program has entered public schools and public libraries in many states of the United States, including Mississippi.
这个活动就是由一些穿着奇装异服的人给小孩子们去阅读 LGBTQ 类的书籍。
This event is designed to read LGBTQ books to children in weird costumes.
他们的目的就是把这种 LGBTQ 的性观念灌输给小孩子。
The purpose is to teach children about the ideas of gender identity according to the LGBTQ ideology.
小朋友们，如果将来你们听到有这种活动，要远离它。
Children, if you hear about drag queen story hours, please stay far away from it.
他们就是要用一所谓的多元、平等、包容的名义去告诉你，其实你可以做一个手术，切掉你身体的某个部位，注射一些的激素来改变自己的性别。
They'll say it's okay for you to do a surgery, cut off some part of your body, injecting some hormones to change your gender in the name of diversity, equality, and inclusion.
他们让你怀疑你是男孩还是女。
They want you to doubt if you are a boy or a girl.
他们想要摧毁上帝制定的性别秩序和人类的常识。
They're trying to destroy the sex order and common sense which is created by God.
他们教给你的谎言会带给你人生很多很多的痛苦。
The lies they teach you will cause a lot of pain in your life.
不要被他们的奇装异服和甜言蜜语给欺骗了。
Do not be deceived by their weird dress and sweet talk.
生活在美国的基督徒，我们是在这样，今天是在这样的环境里面，要为主发光，照亮世界。
American Christians should lighten the world in such an environment.
有一个很有名的基督徒演员，科克·卡梅隆，最近写了一本儿童读物的书，叫《伴你成长》。
Kirk Cameron, the famous Christian actor, recently wrote a book, As You Grow.
这本书教导小孩子如何按照圣经的智慧，依靠圣灵的能力，去结出圣灵的果子。
The book teaches young children to rely on the power of the Holy Spirit to bear the fruit of the Holy Spirit according to the wisdom of the Bible.
卡梅隆尝试进入到公立图书馆，举办给小孩子阅读这本书的活动。
Kirk Cameron tried to hold a book reading event for children in public libraries and to read the book for the children.
可是全美国50多家的图书馆都拒绝卡梅隆的访问，拒绝他在图书馆里给小孩子举办读这个书的活动。
However, more than 50 libraries across the United States refused Cameron's visit and refuse his activity of reading the Christian faith book to children.
其中很多的图书馆，他们可以敞开大门给 LGBT 的人士举办 Dragon Queen Story。
Many of these libraries open their doors to LGBTQ people to host Drag Queen Story。
但是他们拒绝让这位有影响力的基督徒演员，也是作家，给小孩子读这本基督信仰的书籍。
But they refuse to allow the influential Christian actor or author to read the Christian books to children in their libraries。
原来他们推崇的多元化。不包括基督教信仰。
They promote diversity and inclusion, but their diversity does not include Christianity.
他们很鼓吹包容，但是他们不包容基督信仰。
They advocate tolerance, but they do not tolerate Christianity.
这就是美国版的政治正确。
This is the American version of political correctness.
因为我们敬畏上帝，我们当然不认同也不支持 LGBTQ 这一类错误的伦理观念。
Because we fear the Lord, we do not agree and do not support the wrong ethics of the LGBTQ.
当然我们不认同他们的观念不等于我们歧视他们。
But just because we disagree with their ideas, it does not mean that we discriminate against them.
事实上正是因为我们敬畏上帝，所以我们懂得尊重和关爱每一个人，包括 LGBTQ 人。
In fact, because we fear God, we respect and love everyone, including LGBTQ people.
但是我们是基于上帝启示的真理去爱这些人。
But we love our neighbors according to the truth of God.
可是问题是，今天在美国这样一个激进的力量，他们拒绝上帝启示的真理。
However, in America today, the radical activists reject the truth of God.
而危险之处就在于，这一种激进的文化正在被越来越多的人所接受，被人们看作是正常的。
What is dangerous is that the radical culture has been accepted by more and more people and is becoming normal.
而我们这些坚持圣经真理的基督徒，被人们认为是偏激的、极端的宗教人士。
And on the other hand, they think that Christians who hold the biblical truth are radical and extremely religious.
所以在我们生活的这个地方，我们需要更多美国版的王仪去打破政治正确的禁忌，去坚持维护圣经真理。
So we need more and more people in America who are also as brave as Wang Yi in China, who are not afraid of the threat of political correctness to uphold the truth of the Bible.
今天中国的基督徒面对的逼迫是来自政治势力。
The persecution faced by Christians in China comes from the political forces.
而美国的基督徒面对的逼迫目前还主要是来自于文化领域。
And the persecution facing Christians in the United States is currently in the cultural sphere.
但是我相信迟早有一天，美国的基督徒我们面对的逼迫一定会落实到政治层面，甚至是法律层面。
But sooner or later, the persecution of Christians in the United States will turn into a political policy or even the law.
因为如果文化像是一个树干的话，那么政治政策是这个树干上所结的果子。
Because if culture is the trunk of a tree, politics is a fruit that grows on the trunk.
而信仰则是这个树的根。
And religious faith is the root of the tree.
当人们都普遍的越来越多的人拒绝上帝这位真理，这位启示律法的权威的话，那么迟早一天人们一定会根据人和文化的需要去篡改法律。
When people reject God, who is the authority of the law, they will change the law to satisfy the needs of man and the culture.
但是弟兄姊妹，在这样的一种基督信仰迅速衰落的环境里，你的存在就显得特别的宝贵。
Brothers and sisters, in an environment where Christianity is rapidly declining, you are even more precious.
因为夜越黑，光就越宝贵。
For the darker the night, the more precious the light.
所以弟兄姊妹，我们现在要珍惜我们现在拥有的信仰自由。
So brothers and sisters, cherish the religious freedom we have today.
不要浪费这些自由。
Do not waste your freedom.
更不要滥用这些自由。
Do not abuse your freedom.
当我们暂时还有自由空间的时候，竭力的去传福音，为主做见证。
When there is still freedom, do your best to preach the gospel and bear witness for the Lord.
在你的工作场合去说出你的信仰。
In your workplace, speak out for what you believe in.
在你的办公室里表达你的信仰。
Show your faith in your office.
用你的行为言语去见证耶稣基督的福音。
Witness the gospel of Jesus Christ by your actions and words.
不仅传讲耶稣基督成就的救赎，也去捍卫上帝创造的伦理秩序。
Not only proclaim the redemption that Jesus accomplished, but also protect the ethical order that God created.
我们教会有很多种不同版本的福音单张。
Our church has various versions of gospel tracts.
我们放在了那个门口的桌子上。
I put them on the table on the entrance.
所以请弟兄姊妹走的时候每个人拿一点。
So please take some on your way out.
随身带着，放在你的车里，放在你的办公室里。
Take with you in your car and in your office.
随时可以发给需要福音的人。
Distribute it to those who need the gospel at any time.
明年我们教会计划对所有的弟兄姊妹，包括我们的青少年，培训如何用英语传福音。
Next year, we plan to train all the brothers and sisters in the church, including our teenagers, how to share the gospel in English.
因为我们这里的每一个人，我们都有很多很多的机会可以用英语传福音。
Because everyone here has opportunities to preach the gospel in English.
不要因为文化的压力而不敢开口。
Do not be afraid to speak because of cultural oppression.
如果我们现在传福音的勇气能够经得起文化压力的考验的话，
If our courage now withstands the test of cultural pressure,
将来我们才有可能胜过更大的压力。
Then we'll be able to overcome greater pressure in the future.
如果现在只是一点文化的压力，我们就在表达信仰的事情上退缩了的话，
If we're having a little bit of cultural pressure now, and we do not have the courage to express our faith,
那么将来有更大的逼迫和压力来临的时候，就更没有勇气了。
Then when greater persecution and pressure comes, we will lose more courage.
其实令人感到可怕的不是我们会为义受逼迫，令人可怕的是我们根本就不需要被逼迫。
The persecuted for righteousness' sake is not fearful, but what is fearful is that we are not worthy of being persecuted.
因为逼迫还没有来临，我们就早就主动退缩了。
Because before the persecution comes, we withdraw already.
如果是这样的话，我们和为义受逼迫的祝福就无份了。
If so, we have no part in the blessing of being persecuted for righteousness' sake.
我们的信仰不是一个私人领域的隐秘的事情。
Our beliefs are not a private affair in the public sphere.
我们的信仰是公开的。
Our faith is public.
我们的信仰是光照在人前。
Our faith is the light that shines before men.
但是光照进黑暗，黑暗却不接受光。
Light shines in the darkness, but the darkness does not receive the light.
可是虽然黑暗不接受光，黑暗却无法阻止光。
However, even though the darkness does not accept the light, it cannot stop the light.
光终究会驱走黑暗。
Light will eventually drive out the darkness.
耶稣基督第二次降临的时候，他荣耀的光辉会驱走所有的黑暗。
In the glorious light of Jesus at his second coming will drive out all darkness.
当基督第二次再来的时候，他会实行公义的审判。
And at the second coming of Jesus, he will execute just righteous judgment.
他会接他的儿女进入完美的国度。
The children of God will be welcomed into his perfect kingdom.
在他将来那个完美的国度里，普世欢腾的景象会真实的发生。
The scenario of joy to the world will be a reality in the perfect kingdom.
在新天新地里再也没有黑暗了，因为在那里神他亲自的光照我们。
In the new heaven and in the new earth, there will be no more darkness because of for God and the light.
但是在那一天到来之前，耶稣要使用我们在地上为他发光。
But before that day, Jesus uses us today to shine for him.
上帝让我们生活在这个拒绝耶稣的时代。
God has allowed you to live in this age of rejection of Jesus.
因为这个世界需要你。
Because the world needs you.
更确切地说，这个世界需要耶稣。
Actually, the world needs Jesus.
但是谁认识耶稣呢？你认识耶稣啊。
But you know Jesus.
你拥有耶稣的生命啊。
You have the life of Jesus.
你拥有耶稣启示的真理啊。
And you believe in the truth revealed by Jesus.
所以当基督第二次降临之前，这个世界需要你。
So the world needs you before the second coming of Jesus.
你是上帝在这个黑暗的时代里保留的一盏明灯。
You're a light that God keeps in these dark times.
上帝让你来照亮这个世界。
God, you light up the world.
不是凭着你和我的一腔热血，乃是靠着在我们里面的耶稣基督。
Not by your own will, but by Jesus Christ in you.
因为他是真光。
Because he is the true light.
黑暗的势力无法阻止你为他发出的光。
The forces of darkness cannot stop you from shining.
因为耶稣基督已经从死里复活，战胜了黑暗。
Because Jesus Christ, who has been risen from the dead, has overcome the darkness.
我们一起祷告。
Let's pray.
耶稣基督，你已经胜过了死亡，胜过了魔鬼，胜过了黑暗的权势。
Jesus, you have overcome death, you have overcome the devil, you have overcome the powers of darkness.
所以我们盼望你再来的日子，我们庆祝你终极的得胜。
We look forward to the day of your return to celebrate your ultimate victory.
感谢你再来之前，你让我们在地上做你忠心的仆人。
Until you come again, we will be your faithful servants on earth.
求你赐给我们勇敢的心。
Please give us a brave heart.
让我们为真理做见证。
Witness to the truth.
用生命的大能照亮我们所在的世界。
And use the power of life to illuminate the world that we live in.
奉耶稣基督的名。
In the name of the Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.